And then you dive down, you need 1 meter to go down, and then you see, then you just see the white of the ice. But then you come under this, and then your eyes are looking in a distance, and you have the idea that you can look more or less in all directions without limits. That's stunning.
The first surprise is how varied the under-ice landscape is.
The under-ice landscape is full of colors, full of light, full of life. It's like you step into a forest. It's very diverse and it's beautiful.
On the surface, a thick layer of snow makes the flow look fairly uniform. But underneath, the scientists can see that the flow is really a collage of hundreds of pieces of ice of different sizes, shapes, thicknesses, and ages.
In some areas, it's very smooth. In other areas, there's an over-rafted piece of ice sticking out. And it's very variable and different and something new every time you look. And of course, the light is quite nice because it changes with the thickness of the ice in intensity and color.
It's almost like an out-of-body experience. Down there, under this cathedral of ice with all these different colors. And it's almost like psychedelic.
Even though it is expected, they are struck by just how clear the water is. It shows that there's very little phytoplankton in the water column. But there are a few krill in the water, though they're hard to see. So the question is, what are they feeding on?